crossed my mind.
Wow.
But I tell you, Bible says we had even inheritance for our children's children.
Right.
So now I have a new purpose. The first part of my life was about career, and making money and making money. And,
right.
And God gave me an opportunity to do that. Now it's really about them. It's about that inheritance. That inheritance is not only a financial inheritance, but all that wisdom and all that experience that God has given me, I've been able to pass on to them.
What a blessing. What a blessing.
That's why I thank God for my father.
Right.
So many folk in my neighborhood didn't have a dad in the home. Well, my mom remarried. And that was my dad.
Right.
And that was an awesome environment. I had an awesome example of manhood.
Wow.
I had a praying father.
Right.
I have. He's still alive. He ain't dead. Sorry, Dad.
I got you.
He not dead. He yet lives.
Absolutely.
Amen. 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 And there it is. Oh, jalapeno. So that foundation and the wisdom my dad handed on to me, is such a natural response to hand it on to my children. And I think that's my biggest pride and joy. I've done over 200 episodes of television, a dozen film, hundreds of plays, and won many awards and made lots of money. But my biggest pride are my babies.
Wow, what a blessing. What a blessing. Praise the Lord. I guess one of my questions would be, out of the very busy schedule and the things that God has allowed you to accomplish, how do you find time to balance? That's something that so many of us struggle with,
yeah.
Whether we're in entertainment, ministry, law, you know, white collar, blue collar. How do you seem to manage the balance between career, family? How do you do that?
There's a rumor going around town that Tommy doesn't have a job.
Okay.
I want you guys to know that's just the devil. That's a lie, the truth ain't in it. Tommy got a job. I got a job, y'all. Y'all want to know what my job is? I got to be about my father's business.
My God.
I must work the work of him who has sent me while it's still day.
Yeah.
When the night comes.
No man can work.
Can't
yes, sir.
Work. No women either. Some of y'all ain't working nowhere. So I tell you, as long as I'm doing God's word
right.
And God's will, he makes a way for me.
My God.
I think I'm on television 3 to 6 times a day, every single day.
Right.
You know what that means? There's 6 checks coming. Oh, glory!
Hallelujah.
There's 6 checks coming in a day.
I know that's right. Yes, sir.
So I say, I'm sorry. My baby want to see daddy. I'm on a plane.
I got you.
Because the check's already in the mail. Glory to God.
I got you.
So it's about making that time. It's about prioritizing. And it's difficult. I have a youth ministry. I travel all over the country and the Caribbean islands, motivating young people, letting them know they're beautiful, they're powerful, they're valuable. Every city, I'm in another city, letting them young people know how awesome they are. I work with a dear friend of mine, Jerome Letmanson, with the Christian Business Network here. They have an entrepreneurial program where we go to different schools all over the country, teaching young people how to be business owners, how to start their own business, not just be consumers, but manufacturers.
Great.
Not how to just be followers, but leaders.
Right.
So the need is so important that we're out there with ministry, but God also gives us the force me the opportunity and the favor to be able to say, okay, stop. I need to pause and go see my babies.
Right, great.
I need to hug and get some hugs and kisses. That rejuvenates me to go out and finish my job.
Absolutely. Tell me about, you talked earlier about the TV One show, Who's Got Jokes. Tell me something about some up and coming projects. What are you doing now? Some
other things. There's so many things going on. I'm doing a lot of producing and directing now.
Okay.
In fact, there is a black theater festival that's going to be having a big, have theater folk from all places, from all over the country. They meet in Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and a show that I directed and produced and perform in is going to be performing very soon. I'm excited about that. And I'm producing a couple of films now, have a film deal with a major film company, so we're producing projects. One I'm really excited about the a young man in the ministry who has fallen. But his process, that he has used that process, that test as a testimony, go out and empower other men to be great leaders in their families, in their household. And not only did I play the lead in that, but also one of the producers in that. And
great.
I mean, there's so many awesome things going on. I write children's books.
Right.
I have a character education program, so in schools all over the country, and have a distribution deal for home entertainment, bringing great gospel comedians like Broderick Rice.
Yeah.
Great. Brother AJ in Jacksonville. So we have more of those projects coming up. I think it's so important that we laugh. Absolutely. That we enjoy ourselves.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
The church is not just about standing up frowning and telling the world what they cannot do and right. what you're going to hell to do.
Right.
But I have something to laugh about, something to smile about. Delight yourself in the Lord and
yes,
he will
sir.
Give you the desires of your heart. Lord, I'm delighted to be one of
yes,
you.
Yes, sir.
I got something to smile about.
Hallelujah.
So I that's part of my ministry.
Great.
Is bringing laughter and fun to the world, particularly our younger generations.
I got you.
Our young people, you are beautiful. You are awesome. You are amazing.
Amen.
But what are you doing with your beauty?
Mm.
So what? You're beautiful.
Mm.
We are beautiful. Mm. God made us that way. Everything he made was good.
Absolutely.
But it takes me to mess up the goodness that he gave me.
My God.
The ministry is to go out and let young people know how beautiful you are. You are our tomorrow.
Absolutely.
You are our today.
Absolutely.
It's amazing. I go back to the old church I grew up in, and many of the preachers on the pulpit are dead and gone now.
Wow.
The seat grandmama used to sit in is vacant now.
Right.
So our world is changing constantly.
Right.
So now not only are we looking at our young people today, but sooner or later they're going to be on the mother's board and the deacon's board and preachers and pastors. So we have to train them today
Absolutely.
On how to be great leaders.
Absolutely. Praise God. What a word. What a word. So, are there any young men or young women who are watching who have a desire to be in theater and film? What would be your words of encouragement to a person who wanted to do, who wanted to become the next Tommy Ford? What would you say to them?
Pray. You've got to study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So often we want to start at the top and work our way up.
That's so true.
We want to go to bed a blunder and wake up a wonder. Hello. You want to sing like Tommy Ford, but wake up tomorrow singing like Rand Allen.
I got you.
But it took some work.
Absolutely.
And there's a whole lot of folk who can sing but don't have the anointing
My God.
That God has put on his life.
Absolutely.
So it's one thing to have a gift, but to have an anointed gift
Absolutely.
And to be able to use that gift to build the body of Christ, that's a whole different program.
Absolutely.
So I have to understand that my purpose, that my gift is my ministry.
Yes.
To build the body of Christ. If yes. I be lifted up, I'll draw them.
Yes.
So once they are drawn, how'd you make it, Tommy? How'd you do it, dog? How'd you do it? How can you make it? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything else is yours.
Praise God.
So I say to that young man and that young woman, first, you got to study. You got to educate yourself.
Yes.
Not only academically.
Yes.
But I have to educate myself spiritually. I have to be spiritually sound and spiritually full. So when those temptations that we talked about, a little earlier, when they come along, that I know that I can look to the hills with coming my help. I don't have to look to crack. I don't have to look
my God.
To gin and juice and
my
Alizé
God.
And,
my God.
And Pookie Nem.
Yes.
I look to the hills with
yes,
coming my help. So my encouragement to young people is study.
Yes, sir.
The word and academics as well.
Praise God. Praise God. And amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. And so your parting words to this congregation, all to our TBN viewers, what will be your parting words?
My parting words. Where's the camera? Bye.
One last time, a great big TBN thank you and God bless you. A hand of gratitude to our Christian brother, Tommy Ford. Let's give God praise for him. What a man of God. Thank you. Come on, another hand for Tommy Ford. Another hand for Tommy Ford.